What's going on, smart people? Quick video today. I'm trying to get a lot of work done and studying today, so I don't have too much time to make a video. But I thought for today's video, I'd talk about something that is coming up. Final exams are in way less than 2 weeks. Pretty much, today is Saturday, so not this next Monday, but the Monday afterwards, final exam week starts here at MSU. So I figured I'd talk a little bit about what my exams are going to be covering and how I'm feeling about them so far. I'm going to have final exams for three different classes: classical mechanics, quantum mechanics, and mathematical methods. Now, for classical mechanics, what we can expect to see on the exam is probably going to be things like rotational dynamics and kinematics of the inertia tensor, as well as getting into the different formalisms of classical mechanics, namely the Hamiltonian formalism. To be honest, I'm really not too worried about it so far, just because when we went over rigid body motion, I'm very, very comfortable with the inertia tensor. Something that I can probably brush up on a bit more are Euler angles, and really making sure I understand how to go into different reference frames using those angles and rotations. But other than that, I feel pretty good. I don't know if we're going to get into canonical transformations on the final exam, because we haven't had a homework on it, even though we've been learning about it in class. So a lot of the stuff that's going to be on the exam, we actually haven't even talked about yet, meaning we haven't talked about what the exam will exactly cover. So this is just speculation here. I'll probably talk more about it later. So really, rigid body motion and Hamiltonian formalism for the exam. As for quantum mechanics, I'm sure we can expect a lot of what was covered on our last quiz, which were the different pictures of quantum mechanics, so the Schrodinger picture, the Heisenberg picture, and the Dirac picture, as well as a lot of material on the quantum harmonic oscillator. If I had to bet on it, I would assume there might be a little bit on angular momentum, maybe a bonus question, because that's sort of what we're finishing this semester off of. So if the exam is anything like the quizzes, it's going to be a tough one. Last but not least is math methods. In math methods, I'm pretty safe in saying there's going to be two topics on the exam: complex analysis and tensor analysis. I feel really good with tensor analysis. It's kind of my bread and butter, I think. So that's not something I'm worrying about too much. He does have a little bit different notation than I'm used to, which is something I should just work on becoming more fluent in and converting from that to something I'm more familiar with. I'm a bit more worried about complex analysis just because I haven't really had a formal class in it. It's a little bit new to me, but I did just pick up a book on complex analysis by Alfers. Alfers is their name. So far, I like this book pretty well, and it's up until now, I didn't really have any resources to learn complex analysis by myself, except for, like, the math methods textbook, which only gets you so far. That's not really a book that you learn from. It's one that you learn, and then you use it as sort of like a reference book. So I'm glad that I picked up this little complex analysis book. I like it so far. I haven't gone too deep into it to give any recommendations or anything like that, or a real review. Based on the time I have left, I think what's going to occupy my time the most is studying complex analysis and classical mechanics. I know I said I'm not too worried about classical mechanics, but the thing with that class is that a theoretical knowledge is really not enough, at least for me. It's hard to take the theory and think, well, what kind of questions could you ask me that has to do with these kinds of equations or derivations? I need to solve as many problems as I can to really get a grasp of the material that we've gone over. I'm really comfortable with the derivations that we've done, but it's hard for me, like I said, to know, well, how could he phrase a question relating to this material? So if I spend a lot of time on that, I should be good. As for quantum mechanics, our professor just has a tendency to ask sort of fair but unpredictable questions, if that makes any sense, to where it's like, man, I wouldn't have thought that they'd ask that, but I understand why you would think I should need to know that, or rather that we should be expected to be able to solve those kinds of problems. So when it comes to quantum, that's the one where I think I'm on the firmest ground. I don't really look back at any of the material we've covered and look at a section as a weak point of mine. I think I have a pretty firm grasp of everything we've covered. So for quantum, it's not going to be tackling any specific weak points, rather polishing off what I think I already know. Basically, what I'm getting at is if I were to take the quantum final tomorrow, I think I would roughly get the exact same grade as I would if I were to take it a week and a half from now. So really, the process is just going to be keeping up with it. Let me know in the comments section if you have finals coming up, which one do you think you need to prepare for the most? For me, it's probably a toss-up between classical mechanics and math methods. So let me know in the comments section, and I'll see you guys there.